This is Chinese rocket Long March 6, which carried and successfully placed a telecommunications satellite on 6 November 2020, which is described as world's first 6G satellite. I know, we didn't get 5G yet, and we are talking about 6G, but we should be aware about it, right? Hey guys, Nehuma here from Gadget Gravy. Welcome to today's talk about 6G. Enjoy the video. Let's discuss what it is. That means, what is 6G? Like other Gs, 6G is also 6th generation wireless network system. In every generation of wireless networks, more wide bands are used and antenna technology get complexed. International Telecommunication Union or ITU standardize this wireless network system in every 10 years or so. 6G is not the official name yet, but it's the successor of 5G. The next new technology, which is not compatible with 5G, will be called as 6G. So, what will be the speed of 6G? Various reports says that it will be 100 times faster than 5G. In 5G, we are getting or we will get around 1 Gbps speed. So, in 5G, we can get more than that, of course, around 100 Gbps. What will be the spectrum of 6G? Well, it's not definite yet, but FCC has opened up 95 GHz to 3 THz range for experimental 6G spectrum. Today's 4G technology uses around 2 to 8 GHz of spectrum band, and 5G uses from sub 6 GHz to around 39 GHz range. So how fast 6G can be? According to Samsung's 6G Vision report, 5G was designed to achieve 20 Gbps peak data rate. In 6G, we aim to provide the peak data rate of 1000 Gbps and user experience data rate of 1 Gbps. Now you can imagine the future little bit. When will it be launched? Just few months ago, China sent world's first 6G test satellite, and researchers around the globe are working on it. Even in that time frame, standard of 6G will most likely get completed around 2028, and the deployment might start around 2030. Around that time frame, we'll get devices with 6G capability. Now you can say that 2030 is very far. Why we are talking about it now? Because 6G is giving us the glimpse of future. The future that we have seen in science fiction movies is going to be reality. Some representative categories of 5G connection like EMBB, URLLC and MMTC will be improved a lot. Whereas some other technologies will be developed and artificial intelligence will be improved a lot. Truly immersive XR is the new future. XR is extended reality. It's a mixture of AR, VR and MR. Now current AR systems are required around 58 Mbps of speed to get around 8K video footage. In that comparison, truly immersive XR will require 1 Gbps of speed for 16K Ultra HD video. According to some report, in 2030, the market size of VR will be around $44.7 billion and AR will be around $87 billion. We can use 3D hologram display on our mobile devices, and to process that enormous amount of data, we need high-speed internet. Definitely higher than 4G, even beyond that 5G, we need 6G. At that time, we will be present at stadium or any concert without even physically being there. We can do the group meetings from miles away. Yes, we do it now, but we can do it in 3D in near future. With the help of 6G, doctors can diagnose in a more efficient way, or they can do surgery more accurately. Now that we know some of the possibilities of 6G, now the question is, how will we implement it? Well, we need more hardware and software to achieve that hyper-fast internet connection and enormous amount of real-time data processing, that too in very low latency. To experience real-time application over internet, end-to-end latency should be 1 millisecond. And then we can get latency of less than 10 milliseconds on immersive XR. And we need as less latency as possible. Because in remote surgery or industrial automation, high latency can bring disaster. So the reliability needs to be improved 100 times more than current 5G. In 5G, massive MIMO is introduced to provide better throughput and better spectrum efficiency. In 6G, that technology will be enhanced to cope up with the difficult propagation characteristics of terahertz band. Not only that, several new technologies will be developed because network coverage is extremely important. the number of connected devices will grow rapidly, and it is estimated about 10 to the power 7 devices per square kilometer will be connected to 6G. This is 10 times higher than connection density requirement of 5G. Let's see what is terahertz technology. Terahertz band can bring huge amount of data, and this can fulfill 6G's required Tbps speed. But there are some problems with terahertz band. With the increasing frequency, the chances of path loss also increase, and the penetration power gets lower. To overcome this problem, more antenna cells are needed. These are called picocells, and we need lots and lots of them. Denser the area, higher the number of antenna needed. We don't yet know what its environmental impact will be, but it will consume much less power than the microcells of 5G. 6G is just not a technology. It's part of geopolitical race too. China and USA are now in race of 6G. China already made a huge leap by sending their 6G test satellite. So we shouldn't be surprised if US sends one. The first to develop 6G and get patent will be the winner of next revolution. China is already leading in 5G network. So US will try to dominate it in 6G. Of course, the healthy competition is good for consumers. China's Huawei has begun the research in their Canada lab and ZTE in Hong Kong. USA is not behind. Alliance for Telecommunication Industry Solutions, or ATIS, USA's telecom standard developer, already launched Next 6G Alliance for 6G research. The members are huge name in telecommunication industry, which includes Apple, Qualcomm, Ericsson, Mavenir, etc. Other countries are not sleeping too. Japan began research in 2020. Sony, NTT, and Intel formed a global platform to work on 6G. Japan is planning to launch it in 2030. Hexa X is Europe's project on 6G, and Nokia is leading it. So you can guess that an army of engineers, scientists are working on 6G network. In few years, we can see flying taxis, super advanced medical technology, real-time holograms, etc. 6G is a sleeping monster. In few years, we'll see a hype about it, and lots of product will be marketed as 6G. But don't get confused with that. Like Wi-Fi 6 is not 6G. If your fiber optics broadband gives you 6 Gbps speed, that is not 6G. We have to wait. Let's enjoy the 5G right now, because most of us haven't even experienced that. That's it, guys. Hope you got some interesting facts about 6G in this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe this channel. Till then, bye bye, and I will see you in the next video.